Okay, so I don't have so many things to say after all this. I am going to go to Alex and see and learn to me how to do all this planning. And yeah, but I am going to be your resident once more. And moreover, I am going to send you my fellows and my co-workers, because it's really very difficult, my disclosures. And we know that preoperative planning. And when I was young, we were doing with templates in the X-rays, and we were trying to do the preoperative planning. And at that time, it was very difficult to conceptualize the 3D dimensions and the 3D picture from two-dimensional images. And this is still today. We have a concept of how it's the normal shoulder, and then we have to do in our minds to imagine how is the destroyed shoulder from the CT scans, from the two-dimensional images we have from the MRI of the CT scan. And I think that the most important thing is the preoperative planning that we have now the ability to do, and there are many softwares in the market. And what all of them are doing is that they are taking the two-dimensional images, do it three-dimensional. And then we can check where we are going to put the implants, how medialized we are going to put, how well is going to be the contact with the glenoid, how well is going to be the central peg into the vault, and what is going to be the inclination and the retroversion. And putting all there, then we can have a 3D movie of the joint that we of the motion that we expect to have. And all this is a real new world. And however, whatever way you try then to reproduce it in the surgery, it's certain that you are going there much more well prepared. And this is the important thing. It's not that you are going to use PSI navigation or a boiling, try to calculate where to put, or mechanical instrumentation. The idea is that you are very well, much more well prepared of what you are, what you want to do. Even if you don't know exactly what is the right thing to do, you are going to do something and that you prepared. And then you can check the results, see what you succeeded, and see how you can do it better. And of course, there are the easy cases, like the case today, and then you can say, okay, there's no need for navigation, there's no need for PSI, it's just such a straight case. But it had a 50 degrees retroversion of the humeral head. And this is something that you cannot see in the X-rays, and you can have an idea when you see the CT scans. But when you see it live in real three-dimension pictures or in 3D printed models, then you can understand exactly how you can do it. And we use this software, and this software has the advantage that we can use any kind of implants, and it is accessible easier to us. But every company now has a system, and, sorry. Every company now has a system, and these systems are more friendly to the operator, because they have the implants and you can use the implant. We can't do this by ourselves. We need a technician. And but you are forced to use the implants of the of this company. So this is what I was trying to do now. And I know that there is a lot of way to go, but now I feel more confident when I go to the operating theater, even if I use navigation or not, or I use PSI implants or not, or just able that before the operation, I have an idea of what I'm going to do. Thank you for the attention.